Me?
Yeah, go for it.
Okay. testing. Is this mic working?
How's everything sound, guys? Are we level? Are we good?
I wish I could see the chat, but I'll live. Guess I'll continue talking.
Ali said you're good.
Oh, we're good. Great.
You good? Okay, so music volume's all good compared to our volume. I'm having to like shout across the room right now, but so don't go off of my voice.
Yeah. Oh, I can somewhat see it. Okay, we're good. Hi, Allie. Perfect.
Now we're good?
Yeah.
I don't know what I just clicked on. Might have been to, like, turn the stream off. It's not gonna change. We're still good on. Not gonna go ahead and mute.
Okay, great.
Now you talk to the chat.
How is everyone doing?
I don't know how much of a lag there is between.
Well, we'll figure out.
Yeah. I guess it's not as important on like the unboxing ones generally.
Yeah.
Good.
Super duper. There's a bit of a lag.
A little bit. Maybe the lag's on their side. Maybe Ellie's just slow. Well, actually, no. You're on the chat, right? Unmute your chat for yourself.
Hello? Miracles. Kaya was going to join us, but she decided not to. Last minute.
About 10 seconds. That's not too bad. Under the couch.
Thank you.
ready to go?
It's time.
Someone's alarm.
Is there no sound? Or is it just...
slow.
Oh, no.
I did unmute the mic.
Are you sure?
Yes. No, the mic is definitely unmuted. Guys, what's going on?
There's no music either.
What?
Oh, it works now. Oh, I guess? Okay.
Wait, what? I'm seeing sound on the meter. We have sound on the meter. What's going on?
So I guess we're gonna have to redo our intro.
Oh no. Yeah,
it's
so weird. Yeah, the music's not showing.
It was too good to be true. We can't be on time. We were doing so good.
Do we have any music now, or just no? Runatic is too powerful for that. Still no music? Okay. Oh well. Well, we get to listen to music, then.
Yeah.
Because I'm not gonna... I'll just bump up the background music and then maybe you guys can hear it.
That should help, somewhat.
No, I'll just put it up loud.
We'll do, like, a quick test to see if, like, you guys can still hear me, like, over the louder music playing in the background.
Yeah, is this good?
Yes, they can hear us. Okay.
Okay, cool. Okay.
Well, time to do our intros again.
Yeah, I'm gonna pop on the other camera. There. Our product.
Thank you. Okay. I doodled on the box. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll let Panda start us off again.
Product cam's over here. Wait, anyways. Hi, everyone. Welcome to our January unboxing live stream. Again, for the second time.
And I'm like, no,
oh, well, no. Okay. We'll do it live. Okay. So, we are joined today by our special guest, Bree.
Hi. I'm one of the artists for RarezHut's, and I drew the Christmas card of Maria Cross. It's nice to meet you all.
Okay. Maybe do a shorter intro so we don't take too long here. So, hi. Basically, everything's going to be going more or less how we've done it in the past. So, if you see something you like and you're interested in, we are taking offers. So you can ideally send us an email at sales@rareset.net. There's some info down below with all the procedures, as it were. So, you know, we'll be getting back with people within the next, I don't know, probably like 3 or 4 days to, you know, get them back with their offers. Okay. And otherwise, we'll go ahead and get started here.
Great.
So let me move our microphone really quick and get this box out of the way. So
I actually... alternatively, since there are a few of my friends watching this, you can just shoot me a Discord message and I'll relay it back to Panda and Val.
That works too.
As long as you get a hold of us in some way, then, you know, we're good. Want to do the honors here?
I would.
Okay, cool. Still on screen. I can't remember where I put the cutoff here for like the product cam.
I'll just.
Was it a good idea to?
It's a little bit of a no. It's just dull.
Okay. Oh, we got a box inside of our box here.
Perfect. There we go. It's covering the mic.
Oh no. we'll get everything situated here in a moment. Just, you know.
Should I just rip this top off?
Do whatever you want.
Okay.
So, apologies for loud noises in the microphone right now.
Think of it as extreme ASMR.
Yeah. Extreme unboxing ASMR.
There we go.
What's up, Belle? Oh
my god.
It's just in the background. It's okay.
I love how smoothly my debut is going. Okay.
There we go. Okay. Now we only just have to deal with the box inside of this box. Well, I completely forgot everything that we ordered. It is new to me.
A treat in of itself.
Mm-hmm.
Again?
You can't hear me.
Yeah. Keeps going in and out.
Why is the sound going in and out? The sound is going in and out?
Weird.
Hmm. Give me one moment as I knock everything down here.
I guess I'll just talk to the chat, see if things work. Hi, Butter.
Sound from anywhere else.
Casually adjust my mullet. Make myself look prim and proper. Camera's working a bit.
I'm gonna stop the stream and restart it really quick. So, one moment, guys. We're gonna stop it and restart it.
And we're back.
Are we back now?
Yeah.
Okay, awesome.
I think. Hopefully, like, the audio's working now?
No.
No? Well, we just reset it, so maybe there's the lag.
The music might not be working still, but as long as we have the mic working, that's the important part.
Rest in peace, Allie's tea.
Classic RH stream.
Okay, the light's not blinking anymore.
That's good, at least.
Okay, now is our is everything good?
It's for Solus level ASL. I know, like, signing for drink or, like, thirsty, that's about it. And I think it's like this.
Hopefully you didn't just do something really offensive.
No!
Okay, are we now good? I'm seeing big lines on the audio meter.
There's no stream at all.
What do you mean there's no stream at all?
Just
the platforms. Oh my god, no.
Well, there's audio on their end now, again.
Are you sure it's just not you, Val? Because I'm not dropping any frames or anything. Working over here, right?
Yeah, I think audio but no video.
Okay.
It seems like it lagged. No, actually. I'm just staring at the chat too long.
Okay, we are now maybe good, finally. So I knock everything over once more for good measure. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and assume we're good now. Yes, please believe in us. Thank you. We need your power. Give it to us. Send us your spirit bombs or whatever. Okay. It's a strangely shaped bag, but we'll go for it.
Just a little.
If I... Okay, there's tape over. I'm like trying to like rip through this tape. Pure brute animal strength here.
That's the way to go, man.
Okay, well I can get in here. Okay, so without further ado. Oh no. Okay, there. So let me know if everything looks fine on the product camera. I tried to mess around with it a little bit and make it a bit more zoomed in now, so I'm hoping it's gonna be fine. We'll see. So, to start us off, we've got the album Green from Der Zivet. Let me just check to make sure that is good where that is right there. So give me a couple seconds to make sure I didn't goof anything else up. Okay. Does that look good? I'm glad your son enjoys all the bubble wrap we send. Okay, awesome. We seem good. Okay. Next up, then, we have an unopened copy of the B-side collection from Plastic Tree.
We have another album from Plastic Tree.
Yeah, this one is their slide release, which comes with a bonus little photo card in there. You can actually see the products now? Okay, awesome. Yay. Great. Okay. Next up, then, we've got, they put this in the bag wrong. We've got the single, Sumetai Hikari from Plastic Tree. Cute little cover on that one.
We have the album Dolly, I believe, from Plastic Tree.
Yep. This comes with a little slipcase thing. Gigantic Obi. Next up, I don't know how to say this one, but it is one of the best of albums from the band Shula. I think they released 4 best of albums, because I guess to them, all the songs are the best.
We have Trashland from Der Zivet.
Der Zivet again? Okay.
Zivet.
Trashland, yeah. Okay, next up we have the mail order limited version of the Culset album from Despair's Ray. Comes in this lovely sort of fabric lined slipcase. Very fancy.
We have the album Gemini from Despair's Ray as well.
Mm. Next up we have the single White Day from Wizard.
We have the single Shiny, also from Wizard.
Live distributed one, I believe. Okay. After that, we have the single Sir Dance from Bien. Ooh, now it's actually... I'm gonna move this around. It actually became a little bit too bright.
We have the album Prey from This Marionette.
That one's fine, I gotta show up super well because it's a reflective cover. Okay, next up we have, I think this one's a mini album, maybe? Yeah, we have the, whatever this mini album is from Deshabilles, however you pronounce the name. That's from their, very short, revivals on Undercode, when they were on there for like a week. next up, we have, I don't remember how to romanize this one again, but it's the mini album Something for Lovers by Virtue.
We have Studs by The Studs.
Very inventive title.
I also apologize in advance for any mispronunciations.
I think that's a given.
Yeah.
we're going to have those on a very sad stream. That's good. That's going to happen whether we like it or not. Okay, next up we have the Pop Mania album from Der Zivet.
We have two albums.
The, it's a little bit too bright. I'll try and move that a little bit, see if that makes the product camera a little better.
I'm not sure what album this is, but I think the band is Dummy Children. Ah, Communication by Dummy Children. Big mood!
There we go. Yeah, mini album. There's 5 tracks on there. Super good, sort of like Nagoya K-ish band.
Okay.
Next up, we have some album from a band called Glaz, Less Than Zero. I don't know anything about this. some band from 1991 may or may not be VK.
Who knows?
Probably VK though. They kind of look it a little bit.
We have the album Style from Grass Valley. Mm-hmm.
So they're, I think, like late 80s, early 90s, awesome. Proto VK ish. Maybe?
Good stuff.
Okay, next up we have this single from Nightingale that I don't remember the title of again.
Good band.
Something E Oto. I can read one of the kanjis.
More than I can.
Okay, next up. What's the name of this band? Yoi Dore, I think, is the name of the band, potentially. It was the early band of Ban from Lolita 23Q, and it comes with a really cool photo card in there, which I've never seen before.
We have the album Vanish from Phantasmagoria, and it does include a DVD.
Okay, next up we have, I believe this is the first maxi single from the band S. A classic.
We have the album Earth from Penicillin.
Ooh. Nice and easy. Give us more titles that we can actually read.
Perfect.
Okay, next up is one that I can't read. Some single Akai something from Plastic Tree. Comes with a PV DVD.
I'm gonna hand you to this one.
Well, this is an omnibus album, I know that much. See here? This one has the band's nine, Rirairo Maza, Yoidore, Fior Dreki Rudra, Jackal, Living Dead, Hiskareya, and that's it.
Hmm.
There's two tracks from each of them, and there's a
photo card too.
Two little photo cards in there.
That's awesome. Even better.
One of the Rimaida Maza band, however. How do you even pronounce that? They romanize it out on their email. It's like like down there. Ruel.
Rurial
mother.
Rurial
mother. And then a photo card of Hiskareya.
We have an album that says Merry-Go-Round.
Probably by the band Merry-Go-Round.
Probably.
Yeah, I'm not going to attempt that. Well, actually... Suki to kuro neko to neko arerugi no kimi. So, moon and black cat and cat and my cat allergy, or your cat allergy.
We have Viva from Cascade.
Their one of their albums. I thought that was their best of, but that might not be the best of thing. It was called Viva Best Of. What's up, pal? I can't turn the music up. I think it's also just a quieter song.
We have Issei's Flowers.
And then we have the album Romance of Scarlet by Kuro Yume. It's our first little bundle in here.
Looks like we have merch in this one.
Yeah, there's a bit of merch in here, I see. Yeah, that was dumb. Okay. So, first off, we have a mint case to store your mints. It says Despair Mint, so this may be a good from Despair's Ray. I'm not 100% sure. I've never really thought about mint cases before, but...
That's awesome, though.
It's actually not... You like, slide your mint case into that.
Oh, that's...
It's a mint holster.
We have some buttons from Mixed Speakers, Inc.
As well as a CD, I believe, in there, the identification card. So awesome. You get three pins as well as a CD. We've got, I'm assuming this is a little arm warmer from Despair's Ray for their Tour 2007 Spiral Staircase.
We have some socks from a band.
Plastic Tree?
Awesome.
Are they actually socks?
Yeah, they're socks.
Okay. Long socks. Okay, we got some long socks from Plastic Tree. This is a little Puda logo there.
Something in here.
Can I open this and figure it out? You can go on with the next one, if you know who those are.
We have a little set of photos from Despair's Ray. We have another little photo set of Despair's Ray. And two more photo cards from Despair's Ray.
Get everything back in here. Okay, so this is a little travel kit from Gak. For like Diablos, has like a bunch of like little bottles. You can put, I don't know, whatever you want them. A little bit of shampoo,
I'll let you
something.
Handle this
I don't
one.
Know. Okay, next up we have a book by Yuki of Jinkaku Radio.
Oh, the mint case belonged to Despair's Ray.
I think so, yeah. I'm pretty sure. There's a lot of Despair's Ray stuff in here, so I'm gonna go ahead and assume that's the case there. Okay, next up we have the Avex Entertainment official sampler, which is a CD and little booklet here featuring the bands Cannibalism, Megamasso, D, Marty Friedman featuring Andrew WK, because of course, Ryu, no, God, I'm forgetting his name. Who's the vocalist of Lunacy, do you know?
I think it starts with an R.
Okay, the vocalist of Lunacy, K, J, and Kiyohara. Now you can see him there. Assuming the glare isn't like too bad on this thing since it's in the plastic. Yes.
We have a mirror, I believe, from Mix Speakers Inc.
Yep. Little tiny pocket mirror.
Yeah.
Okay, and the final thing in there. Is a little keychain strap thing from Despair's Ray. I'm assuming early Despair's Ray because it kind of has the, like their mania thing that they kind of had going on early on. Apparently, it looks like you can open the coffin, but I don't know what's in there. Probably a tiny little skeleton.
Sounds cute.
What's up, Belle? A ghost? Okay, well, I'm not going to open it here. We already have enough ghosts here. Okay, next up we have some sort of Jishuban Club privileged CD from Plastic Tree. I'm assuming a comment, but I don't know. It doesn't really say what release it's for or anything there.
We have a mini CD from Laureen Fransales.
I can't speak French, so
your
guess is as good as mine. Okay.
I know Welsh, and that's about it.
I don't know how much that's going to help us with VK.
Maybe. Not at all.
Okay, next up then, we have the live distributed CD Rubble from Leprecha. This was one of their very first releases, I believe. From 2006, maybe? Somewhere around there. Then we've got the... Privileged DVD, that's a Wizard in Korea, just, I guess they went on vacation.
We have
this is the home videos.
Valentine and White Day from Wizard.
This is another Jishuban Club privilege CD, it seems. Is that a CD case? That's a weird CD case. Next up, we have a live distributed CD from the band Jakuda. This was their the version that was released at Nanva Rockets. Yeah, so this is the another version of that Jakuda CD. This one was released at Takadanobaba area. Well, we're going to have this archived up on YouTube, so you can always go back and rewatch any part you missed.
Oh, really? That's so cool.
It is.
I'm still like learning the basics of Welsh, but not enough to say that I'm like fluent, but I'm like, I know a bit.
Okay, next up we have another comment CD from Plastic Tree. This one you got if you bought three of their singles at the same time.
We have CD from Sugar.
Is a PB making of DVD for some song I don't know the title of. Next up we have the live distributed CD Alice from Second Effect. This was it was released in 2007 and limited to 50 copies apparently. So
we have Toxic of Picture from Second Effect.
Might be a DVD? I can't remember. I think this one is. Yeah. Maybe? Yeah, it says DVD on there. So this is one of their PV DVDs, I believe. It's in a weird little paper bag.
We have Emma Dara from Laputa. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and next up there is the...
Hi, Callie!
There is the full album Chandelier from Plastic Tree. They're, 2006 full album. Okay, next up we have whatever this single is from Pasha.
We have Saito Magnus from Gamorrean Baron.
The other way around.
Other way around.
They're modest small cover band. Not actually, but that's what they sound like.
With a little bit of a gothic influence. Some Solomonic magic.
Just moving stuff out of the way here for a bit. So you have some room. Okay. Okay, next up we have another single from Decibels. This was also during their limited revival period on Undercode.
We have a Phantasmagoria tribute, which has a variety of different bands.
This features the bands Kiboya Hanpo, Dali, Hertz, Bergerac, Anju, Ark, Bagurke, Nega, Siva, and Doremidan, all doing various covers of Phantasmagoria. Okay, next up we have another single from Plastic Tree. Comes in a cool little transparent case. I mean, I guess most cases are transparent, but you can see all the way through it.
We have a CD from Nightingale, and it comes with a sticker, I believe.
Yeah, this was, I believe, one of their first live distributed CDs. I can't read the title of it, but you know, it's that one.
We have
very a rare CD
single from Phantasmagoria.
Okay. Next up, we have the I'm assuming best of album. Historic Flowers from Der Zebet. It's a two-disc album with a total of 28 tracks. And a nice little double case there. Thank you.
I have no idea what this is, but I like the little troll guy on the back.
That is Despair's Ray, I believe. I'm pretty sure.
Oh, thank you.
This might have been like an alter ego thing of Tisperis Ray. I'm not 100% sure, but
awesome.
I'm pretty sure it's related to them. There.
Oh boy. Gils de Raz, because.
And next up, it is the single Orange Iro no Object from the band dot 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 dot. That's the band's name.
Really?
Yeah, it's pronounced Silence from the band Silence, which is a side project of the vocalist So from Imure and some other people.
We have an album from Cascade.
It is Patifuru Saruman Life. Whatever the heck that means. But it's got a disturbing monkey on it. Made out of disco balls.
We have the album The Ends by Ends.
I have no idea. I never heard of this or anything. Whatever it is, it came out in 1996. So if you know what Ends is, or The Ends, then well, there you go.
We have a album, Cascade, from Dance Capricio.
The other way around.
Is it? Oh.
Cascade's a band.
Ah.
So the single Dance Caprico from Cascade. Then after that, we have the album Sensual World from New Vogue.
Riva, that's about it. Don't you handle this one?
Yeah. Okay, so next up. This other way. We've got the single, is this the single? Maxi single, La Nekajism, from the band Maredi Crea, which was the early band of Kai, I think, from Gazette?
Hmm.
Something like that. And it comes with a lovely little photo card, which is probably pretty rare, because I mean, it's pre-Gazette. And it comes with a photo card, so, wow.
Leave it to Allie to know her history.
The singer from Soft Ballet? Okay, awesome. Thanks, Allie. Okay, next up we have the single Celluloid Closet from Die Vice.
We have Cold Prey from Chariots.
Move these down. If you want to make an offer, ideally send it to us in an email. That's going to be probably the easiest way, so we don't have to, like, it doesn't get like lost in the hustle and bustle of the chat. Okay, next up we have something that looks like Rob K. It is a album, maybe? Orange Ball from a band called Sheen, potentially, or the other way around.
We have Symphonic. Bucktick in Berlin.
Got to put the Sheen CD up there. There we go. next up, we have the single Namae no Nai Hana from Plastic Tree.
We have Ghost from Plastic Tree.
Ooh, and after that, man, why would they wrote, it's like black on black, black text on black background. We have some sort of CD called Under the Worst from a band called Ovurato? Oblat, maybe? I don't know, it looks rare, whatever it is.
We have a CD from La Mille.
Yeah, so we've got, this is the live distributed CD Versus God. That was distributed at the last live of Lemuel, I believe. Incredibly rare CD. So, you know, if you're a Lemuel fan, right there.
Not sure what this is, but there's an infant on it.
This is the live distributed CD Baby Acoustic Version from the band S. Comes with a little ticket from the concert that it was from, the concert stub, so you can pretend that you went and saw them back in the day.
We have a CD from ECP and Pasha.
Pasha, yeah, the single Mother. Mother. Mazda.
It seems like almost every band has to have at least like one single named Mother.
Probably. It's part of the like VK law. You get arrested otherwise.
Yeah.
Okay, next up we have the live distributed DVD Graduation and Departure, which features V-Doll, Phantasmagoria, and Ichini Zeto Ichini, as well as another little ticket stub.
Agnes Day, Leprecha.
Yeah. This is another really early single from Leprecha there.
We have a, like an Edison massage CD from Plastic Tree.
Massage CD?
Is it message or... it says
that
massage.
That actually does say massage CD. Oh.
Okay.
So, if you want to, like... maybe it's like an ASMR thing where, like, you know, the members of Plastic Tree are giving you a massage.
Oh, that sounds terrible.
Oh, hey, you. She was underneath the couch. Next up, we have a live distributed CD from... Kikyo something night.
We have the B type of Cold Prey from Chariots.
Yes, there were doggy shaking noises. She had to do herself a little shake.
She was thirsty.
Mm-hmm. Okay, next up we have the mini album No Kemono from Lady, which also comes with a little photo card there.
We have Darker Than Darkness from Bucktick.
Lovely album.
If Bird is in here, you should get that.
Okay, next up, we have the DVD High Style Paradox 5 featuring Nega, Kiboya Hampo, Ark, Clear VO, Chariots, Dolly, Siva, Anju, and Hertz.
We have a CD from Chariots. I'm not sure.
I don't know the kanji either.
We have a single from Despair's Ray. Should know the song because it's one of my favorites. Just recognize what it looks like.
It's the one with a really long name.
Yeah, that one.
Yeah. Okay, and then we have an unopened copy of whatever this CD is, or double CD rather, from Kisaki Project featuring Jui. It's got a full album and then a single in there.
Eyes Mirage is the band. Symmetry by Eyes Mirage.
This is a all-female VK band.
Ooh,
from
awesome.
What I'm remembering. Another exceedingly rare thing. Really hard to find. We've got the double DVD, yeah, two disc DVD for Lovers by Kisaki Project, also featuring Jui.
We have All Mood, Children of Evolution.
Is that gonna get us like banned? YouTube. There's a big space between nude and the rest of the title.
Mm-hmm.
Next up, we have the DVD Reincarnation from Phantasmagoria, which has 9 music videos and then a bunch of live songs.
We have Valentine from Wizard.
Some of these
FBI, open up!
Rip.
We have a single from Sugar.
Yeah. It's the one that the PV Making Up DVD was from. This comes with a PV DVD. So you can buy them both together and you can see how the music video to that song was made. Okay, next up we have a split live DVD between V-Doll and Phantasmagoria, which also features a recording of like the session with members from both of the bands playing together.
We have Nice and Liplow from Penicillin.
Lipple. next up, we have the live distributed CD Fragments Voice from Kisaki, guest vocalist Jui. So I think that might have been before Kisaki Project was a thing.
We have No Imagination from Phantasmagoria.
Wow. Calling themselves out. Okay, next up we have the live distributed DVD, it's from the Neo Culture tour, one man tour of D, and features two, music video making ofs on there.
Maiden from Metascretal. Good band, if you haven't heard of them.
Okay, next up we have the split single Darker versus Deeper by the band Sugar and Imure. Yeah, the D.
We have Sophrophic Tree from...
Leprecha,
yeah.
Yeah. Another great band if you haven't listened to them. And in sort of like the neo... Nagoya K sort of
can't
genre. next up, we have another single from Jakuda. Again, I don't know the title on that one.
We have Curse from Lamiole.
This is the limited edition version that comes in a lovely red case. Getting more things out of the way here.
This.
this, my favorite. I love it. we have a mini album from the band Monokuro Kinema.
We have Garnet from Despair's Ray.
Another classic there.
Mm-hmm.
It has a parental advisory, so if you're underage, you gotta ask your parents before you buy this.
We have Brilliant from Despair's Ray. Sure.
next up, we have the full album Negato Poji from the band Plastic Tree. This was when did this come out? Their 2007 full album.
We have another album from Plastic Tree.
Yeah, I don't know the name of this one. Don't know. That one.
We have Mechanical Ugly Gang from Attic.
Hey, next up we have the full album Utsusemi.
My parents said no.
I'm sorry, Kat. We have the full album Utsusemi from Plastic Tree. This was their 2008 full album. Going in order here.
We have you from Nightingale.
Yep. This way. Right.
We have another album from Nightingale.
I can't help with the title on that one either. This one's the feet one. The other one's the ear one.
We have Kamikaze from Despair's Ray. We have Horizon from Despair's Ray.
So if you're missing anything in your Despair's Ray discography, we got a pretty decent chunk of it, I think, here.
We have Mirror from Despair's Ray.
Another full album. I don't know if that's the limited edition version. I think it isn't. I think it's the regular edition.
Boys from...
Kamikaze Shonen. Mm. Or Kamikaze Boys. Next up, we have the single Raspberry from Di Maria.
We have Squall from Despair's Ray. We have another duplicate of that one really long album from Despair's Ray.
I think this is a different version of it, though. Mm-hmm. So, different CD extra on it. I was going to say before DVDs, but DVDs were out by that point.
They just wanted to put it differently. We have a single from Plastic Tree.
Something, Soranaka Blanco, maybe?
We have a huge anime OB.
Was it supposed to go with one of the CDs?
Maybe?
This one? Maybe? Yes. Okay.
Perfect.
Next up, we have the single Navida Drapu from the band Plastic Tree, which, according to this giant anime OB, was the theme to some anime. Garasu no something. I don't know. I'm not a weeaboo when I watch anime, but maybe someone knows it. Want to check it out?
Yeah.
Next up, we have the single Maria no something, Ringo, maybe? Probably not. From Jakuda.
We have another version of Squall from Despair's Ray, I'm pretty sure?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
And this one comes with a bonus photo card. Move these down.
We have Love Letter Dark Mania from Imure.
Lovely full album. One of their first albums, too.
We have Melancholic from Plastic Tree. Might as well give this to you.
this one is the, I believe, live distributed single, or live sold single, Bangyaru something from the band Jinkaku Radio. It is a ode to all the band girls out there.
We have another single from Plastic Tree.
Yep, this is another copy of maybe a different version of the other one, I don't know.
We have another album from Plastic Tree.
Aroi Tori from Plastic Tree. It is good. See? Sure. Allie knows about the band girl song. next up, we've got another single from Jinkaku Radio. Kind of pretty watercolory cover on that one.
Not sure.
another single from Jinkaku Radio. Looks like Akaon, maybe?
Not sure what the band is, but there's some cute dogs on the cover.
Or Jinkaku Radio. Their infamous dog one, which I think was the second press of that single, maybe, has the dogs on it. Oh. Do you not know about that song from Jinkaku Radio then, Allie? I'll have to show it to you later. I'll post it in the Discord chat. It's amazing. As most Bangyaru themed songs are. Bangyaru Shokokun.
We have a single from Yavi.
Neo-visualism.
Neo-visualism.
I actually know that's the name of it. It isn't, but that's what it says on the cover.
We have a album from Gazette.
Guren. A Guren single.
We have a Red from Gazette. We have Beautiful Deformity, also from Gazette.
The regular edition? Yeah. Regular edition of Beautiful Deformity.
We have a live DVD from Gazette of their Division tour.
Yeah, the regular edition of the Division Final Melt tour.
We have another Gazette DVD of their 2006 through 2007 Decomposition Beauty Tour.
And that one is, I think that, yeah, that was a limited edition on that one.
We have a Golden Bomber DVD.
Allie.
Me. All-Star 2012.
Yeah, the All-Star Matsuri 2012. This one is copy number 7,401. Yeah, I thought so. Huh, I wonder why we bought that one. Must have been a coincidence. Gazette?
Oh,
okay. I'm not even going to try with the title. the Gazette single that has like a million characters in it. You know
we
it.
We have Toxic from the Gazette. More Gazette.
Another version of, yeah, another version of Guren.
Stacked Rubbish from Gazette.
Presumably limited edition, given the nice slipcase.
We have a... Is this a book set, or...?
It's a DVD box set, yeah.
Yeah. Repeated Countless Error from the Gazette.
Yeah, limited edition version of that.
And there's four in there.
I think. Three DVDs and a photo book, I think? If I'm remembering the contents correctly.
We have Pound Fish Cake from Inter.
The other way around.
Is it? Oh.
Yeah, so they're not a UK band, but they're an import order, so that goes elsewhere. There you go, Rob. There's your CD. Okay, next up we have I think this is a full album, Reborn from Gene Machine, which comes with a lovely bonus photo set in there. This is the Type A version that, if I'm remembering correctly, I think this one comes with a full live DVD.
Awesome.
Yeah, it's got a 14-track live DVD. It is a mini album, so and all that lovely Gene Machine there.
We have Fused of Crave.
Rhythm? Or the other way around as well, I think? I don't know. I wouldn't expect anyone to know about Fused of Cave anyways, other than Rob. He'll probably know. I think it's like some old VK guys were in this band.
Not sure, but I like the little horned clown person on the front.
What is their name? I don't remember the name of this band. Let me see if it says inside. Okay, so this is the single, they write it so weird, Aniku Wai Do, Aniku Wai Teda, Unrequited, from the band, Ragaidi, which was another all-female VK band, I believe. There's like barely any info about them, but pretty sure that's what it is. Next up, we have the single Kamisama wa something Iro from the band Ensoku. This was their 2018 single. It actually came out in October of 2018, so relatively new there. Allie. Unless you already bought it. Oh, well, that comes at the end, Val. You can't... You can't do your promotion at the end. Oh?
Like
so do you want a second
rack.
Copy of it, Ellie? for your best friends. Just buy it for one of them. Late VK Santa.
We have Manic Pixie from Liplich.
Limited edition, I think? Yeah, this is the music video.
We have Double Feature from Liplich.
The next couple ones are going to be all Liplich.
We have another thing from Liplich.
Yeah, I don't know the name of that one either. So, that single from Liplich.
Black April from Liplich.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Kat. Maybe next year. You just gotta make sure to actually be good this time. Then you'll get something from Santa.
We have the Best Of from Mook.
Ooh, there you go, Jessiana. The limited edition version, I believe, of Mook's Best Of album, which comes with 16 songs on the first disc, and then a second disc that has a bunch of, like, acoustic versions and unplugged versions of different Mook songs.
We had another CD from Mook.
I don't know the title of this one. it's Mook's 2008 full album.
We have the Worst of Mook.
Mm-hmm. To go with their Best Of, if you want to hear their worst songs. Well, there you go.
At least they're honest. We have another CD from Mook.
Yeah, so we've got the full album 6 from Mook. That might be the limited edition, I believe.
We have a puzzle from
Mook.
Mook.
So this is one of Mook's very first singles, and it comes with a 108-piece puzzle that you can put together if you want. And it comes in a nice little, nice big box, rather. I don't think there's anything else in there. I'm just, like, reading the little sticker there. So I think it's a single plus puzzle.
I think this is another single from Mook?
Yes.
Yeah.
It says Kore Mook Desu, but I know that's not the name of the single. Yeah, I'm doing that right now.
I want the worst you have.
Ah, a connoisseur, I see. Okay, next up we have the single Ageha from Mook. Also limited edition.
We have another single from Mook.
I can never remember the name of this album. It's like Hong Hokyo or something like that, maybe.
We have another album from Mook.
I don't remember the name of this one either, but I don't know. It's one of Mook's earlier singles. You know it. You love it. It's probably going to go to Jessiana as well, anyways.
It says Universal Sigma on it.
Yeah. Got another album from Mook.
We have Kyutai from Mook.
Even more Mook. I swear we're not targeting you, Jessiana. this one is a live DVD from Mook that I don't remember the name of. Also, I'm not looking at it, which doesn't help either. Oh.
Ooh, Lynch.
Oh, yeah. Shirt.
So we have a shirt from Lynch, and it comes with a Volume 9 fan book. Should I open it?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. I didn't know the process show it on, off. Like, shirts.
Yeah, we'll show it off on camera. Okay, so first up, we have the Fan Club booklets. Photos and other goodies in it. Let me show off the shirt here. So this is a size large? Yeah, size large shirt.
Ooh. Oh, that's a nice shirt. Yeah.
It's from Lynch's tour 2015, The Decade of Greed. Really nice shirt. I don't want to keep it for myself, but I won't. Here, you're better at folding stuff.
Yes.
I'm terrible at folding shirts. You work at a clothing store, so.
I do.
Oh. Hey, you want to show it off? Just over there a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, just like out there, because like the product camera's kind of like blocking a little bit when I was showing it off.
Should we set it on top?
I'll probably just put it back in the bag for now. Sure doesn't get too much dog hair on it. Even though Kay is across the room right now.
We have a bunch of fans and some...
Kiryu fans?
More Kiryu fans. Should we show each of them? Okay.
What's going to be the best way to show these fans off? Look at them, terrible.
This one has Mihiro on it.
There. Hope that's showing off well enough. I'm so bad with these fans.
Me too.
Nope, that's the wrong way. There we go.
We have another Mihiro fan. These are all packaged.
Yeah, you can open them up.
Okay.
This is not sealed, so as long as it's not sealed, like, fair game.
To you. Ooh, one with Takemasa on it.
Nice.
Opening for this. Oh, it's on the other side. I'm just blind.
Oh, wrong way. There. I keep, like, trying to hold it open and, like, holding the things wrong and it just goes and closes on me. Mm-hmm. You're a fan of fans? Well, these are some very pretty fans that you can be a fan of. That one's a really cool one. I love black and red, so that one's absolutely my aesthetic.
Mm-hmm.
Another one here from their one of their 2015 tours. Maybe, like, their tour final. I'm assuming, since this is the first fan I've seen that actually has, like, a tour date on it.
More Mihiro. I feel like this is targeting some of my friends.
Maybe, a little bit. just a teensy bit. This one's really cool. Really cool design on that one.
We have another duplicate of that 2015 tour fan.
I didn't even notice.
Another Mihiro.
Yep. I don't know if that was the same one as earlier or not. Might have been.
Another Mihiro. So we have backups.
Yeah.
Get one for you and your mom.
Maybe we have three of these, so you can get one for your mom and your dad. Or whoever you want. You can form your own little Mahiro gang.
Like this one.
Ooh, it's pretty. That was nice.
Got him a fake fan, I forgot his name, and it starts with an M.
It's okay, I don't know either, because I'm terrible
at names. Hashtag pretty dad.
Another one there.
We have another one of Takemasa.
I know these ones that have, like, the members' faces on them are a bit harder to find generally. Mm-hmm. So, kind of a cool thing if you're a Kiryu fan.
Or even if you're not.
Yeah, they're still pretty.
Are these...
Those are for some of these, but I don't know which ones they are. So we have... We'll match them up eventually, but...
This one comes with a lanyard.
We've got a bunch of different little fan holsters, and one of them comes with a giant, like, holster, or not holster, little lanyard, so you can wear your fan around with you.
Are these bootlegs?
Yeah.
We got some bootlegs, y'all.
don't tell the FBI. Again. Yeah, that's not really going to be a good way to show this off. So we've got a recording of the band Ideal. We've got a Del Squel one man, I believe. Part of a Risky Night event, which I think had like last year in Lulubia and something else.
I called out on my way.
We got a split live with last year and Synthetic Mushrooms. One from Lulubia, or Juvia. Another one from Del Squel.
Romantic Romance.
Very VK name.
Jolly Pickles, Bellevue. Bellevue, Babysitter, Remain. Overture, Bellevue.
I still don't even actually have a mini disc player, so I can actually listen to any of these.
Breakout, La Formula, Christy.
Good band. I'm sure they're very cool.
Media, Junk Box. Truth, White, Junk Box.
Yeah.
Romantic Romance.
Again.
Bellevue. Gesundheit. Bellevue, Tarot.
I think that's all the mini discs we have. Now we're back to normal stuff.
I think we have some more down there.
Okay.
Tokyo Heroes DVD has 5 on it.
Yes, is their Video Heroes 5 DVD.
We have Tokyo Heroes 4 DVD.
I'm not sure what's on these ones. Looks like live footage.
We have another DVD. I'm sure what
this one is. Tokyo Heroes Video Heroes 3. Sticker?
There's a sticker and a mini CD, I think. Like, really little. Or, no,
it's just stickers, I think.
The stickers? It was worn like a saw.
Oh, it's a little circular.
It was something circular.
Yeah, just a couple Tokyo Heroes stickers.
We have Gosh from Tokyo Heroes.
Gosh. Fuyuwaru Sekai, I believe. But it does say Gosh on it.
No, unfortunately not yet. We haven't come across any Daoto stuff, but do know that like I got a bunch of Daoto stuff from them, so we might have some around.
I'm pretty sure there's Daoto stuff somewhere. If not in the unboxing, we definitely do have some in our inventory.
You know, all the bootlegs out of the way. That way the police can't find us.
Yeah.
Oh, no problem. We have a bootleg of Bellevue and an Ideal Sacrifice.
Yeah, we've got a bootleg of Last Year, Lunacy Wannabe Band. We've got one of Synthetic Mushrooms.
Bellevue, Remain. Sacrifice, RK Rosebud.
You've got one of Couch Case, their first one man live. Well, where can we run to? We're already in the basement. I mean, I guess there's a window. So we've got window access to the backyard if we need to escape. We've got another bootleg from the band With Sexy. And then another one from With Sexy.
God, I love the names of some of these bands.
Another from Bellevue. Another one from Bellevue. And then finally, one from Bellevue, Lavage, and Vols Reju. Whoever those are. Clear some of the stuff out of the way here.
Ooh, Matt.
Ooh.
We have Heaven's Gate from Danger Gang.
Music video DVD, yeah.
Good, great even girl band, if I might say so myself.
Very good, great.
We have Shangri-La, also from Danger Gang. Yep.
Another music video DVD.
With Sexy and
Masala.
Film of Love Insane.
This was a live limited DVD, I believe. Which, yeah, features revival footage of the bands With Sexy and Vasala. They did like a single revival live back in 2015, I believe, and super duper rare DVD and super expensive as well.
The Velvet DVD.
Nude, PV collection DVD from The Velvet, which was, I think, the remains of the band Velvet Eden. Mm-hmm. They split off from Dada or something and formed their own band. If I'm remembering correctly.
We have E-Boys 2.
Yeah. Omnibus DVD featuring the bands Maruru, Dallas, Aramia, Queen's Q, something I can't read, Peer Q&A, Jack 11, Ouncia, and Dio, Distraught Overlord.
Great.
Yeah.
A tape of sorts.
We have a live distributed VHS tape from the band Deno Oblat for, I think it comes with a music video for the song Razor Baby, and it is signed by all the members.
We have another tape from Shizuku.
Yeah.
Feelso.
Yeah, the Feelso live distributed VHS from Shizuku.
We have an autographed CD, Dokoku, which
the band
comes
that we work with
a little,
Well, one of the bands we worked with.
J-Rock Chibi art.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it comes with a little signed photo card. So this is their mini album, one of their mini albums. And it comes with little bonuses in there, which is pretty cute.
We have something from Art Pop.
73 Shiki. I don't remember what the title of this album is, but it's the full album from 73 Shiki, or Shishishanjiki.
We have a Deep More Deep, number 5, which
is omnibus album featuring Verzel, Marco, Miseria, Kimiwa Boku, I think the name, Divane, Sith, Durandal, GSI, and Cronus. And this one is signed by somebody. There are four signatures on the back, or maybe 5 signatures, but I don't know who they're signed by. Oh, there's also a Chucky inside. Do you know who that is?
Unfortunately, no.
Okay, well, there's a Chucky of somebody. So, if anyone happens to know who this person is, then it's a Chucky of that person. One of the bands from this album, I'm assuming.
Dinky Monologue 9.
Yeah. So another live distributed omnibus album that's also signed by some people I don't know. One of them drew a cute little rabbit.
And a baby.
And a baby. This is featuring the bands Anti-Kythera, Some Guy from the VO, Bask in the Deep, Civi from Dish, and Egg Noir, which is another band of Civi, I believe.
We have Sabbath Black Heretic, Gateway.
Is this signed? Yeah, that is signed. Mm-hmm. Okay, so yeah, we have another signed CD that's the single Gateway by Sabbath Black Heretic. Very mellow sounding name. There you go, Scar.
This looks really familiar.
What is Dish's new name? I forgot. Yeah, it is something really dumb. It's like Dish in the Pantry or something.
Not sure what this is, but the art looks familiar.
This is the single Sekai no Owari Goko from Jin, or sorry, not Jinkaku, from Jikendai Marmot.
We have
not signed, unfortunately.
A
maybe
CD version of no. Okay. One of the DVDs from earlier with Sexy and
yeah. So then we have the DVD collections of Love Insane, featuring With Sexy and Vasala. I'm not sure what's on this one, but or it's a CD rather.
We have Maria from Q.
Okay, it has like a bunch of old demo tape tracks from both of the bands.
The Dishes Are Scheming.
Dishes Are Scheming. Yeah, see, I told you it was really dumb, but I love it, and I love Civi, so I'll deal with a really dumb name. Oh, that was signed too? Yeah. Wow, why are there so many signed things in here? That's amazing. Yeah, so that Hooves single Maria is also signed as well.
We have Dystopia from Acacia.
Yeah.
Which is also signed.
Another really good female fronted vocal.
I feel like everything in this box is signed.
Yeah, that is. That's gonna be amazing.
This is another signed thing from
Love Stripper?
Love Stripper.
Whoever the heck Love Stripper is. Yuki Hana / Aru Kaneto is the name of the single.
Four-letter words. Well, the band is four-letter words, but I'm not sure what the...
Yeah, I don't know either. Gokusai Iro, if I'm reading those kanjis correctly.
Four-letter words, Sentiment for You, also signed.
I don't know who four-letter words are.
Also signed, Persona, Joker.
Hellsona?
Oh, Hellsona?
Hellsona.
Oh, Pelsona.
So it's like Persona, but they can't spell it right. This is one of their live limited mini albums. I think I showed them off in the Discord. I was gushing about them because I've been trying to find their CDs forever. Awesome.
Another signed Dystopia from Acacia. This is signed. Not sure what it is, though.
Sorry? Okay, next up we have a signed CD. I don't know the name of it. Hako something from the band Sally.
We have
and it's signed.
Another single from Dokoku.
Another signed one? Yeah, another signed single from Dokoku. They're... 2015 single.
We have Checkmate from Last Note, also signed.
I don't know who it
is.
I think Endgame is a single. Endgame is the band's name, I think. So Last Note from Endgame. And we might be copyright safe just because it's only playing in the background. I don't know. We'll find out.
Early Grey, also signed. Not sure.
Anti-Kythera? So yeah, the album Early Grey from Anti-Kythera is an album, a mini album. Lovely Guna Tools wannabe band.
We have another autographed copy of Pelsona's Joker and Pelsona's Pandora.
Also signed, yeah.
Also signed, yes.
My god, there's so many signed things.
Insane Family from Q.
Yeah. Not signed.
I don't think so.
Shame.
Could be wrong.
so the insane... Welcome to the Lustful Hoof Show. We have whips and swings and all the toys you need. Tonight, I'll pleasure you to your deepest places. This night, we'll see a paradise culmination. Now enjoy to your heart's content. God, I love VK. Wow. Agreed.
Oh, I must
be. Okay, next up we have a single from Marco. I'm assuming this is the limited edition. It comes with a PV DVD.
Yeah.
I don't know the name of it though. It's four kanjis.
We have Birth from El Dorado.
I need to move these really quick.
Time to move some stuff.
Yeah.
I don't want to know. God, me too.
Yeah, that's probably for the best. Outside of that, though, Hoof is a nice band. They were made out of the remnants of the band Glacier, who was the only VK band to ever come from Okinawa, I think.
El Dorado's Birth.
Oh, chose the micro single?
Sure.
1 second. Find where I put that. So it is that one. Just waiting to make sure that it's... I'm lining this up correctly with the camera. I'm just having to wait for the delay.
There we go.
And you can kind of see it. It's badly glared. But this is their... it came out in January of 2015. So, that one.
We have a single from Lucifer's Underground.
I don't know the name of that one. Something Umbrella. Umbrella. Mini album. Lucifer's Underground was the other, I think, maybe the final band of the vocalist Hina, who was in, like, Azalea and a million other bands back in the day.
We have another Marco CD.
Yeah, this is Something Braku, a mini album. Okay, next up we have a single from the band Lad. Or Rado. By 73 Shiki.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we got another single from 73 Shiki and Chichishan Shiki.
We have Liquid, Beautiful World. Oof, stuck in there. It's a bad thing about OBs.
I think this band was related to the band Wise in some way. And it has a nice, pretty blue CD case.
Oh, this has so much writing on. Press R, Memories. Ooh. Not
oh,
a
man,
real.
I've been waiting to get this CD.
Really?
I didn't know this was in here. This is the live sold single Memories, Not a Real from Caress that was released only during their one day revival, I think it was last year or the year before that. Yay. I've been so much wanting to hear that for, like, years, and if I could ever get my hands on a copy of that.
Well...
I didn't know it was in here.
We have Saliva from Lucifer's Underground.
Another Lucifer's Underground.
I like the art.
Yeah, the art's really cool.
Aw, hell yeah. This is something good ahead. Alice of the Country of Sweets.
Kinadura. Or Kinrel. That's kind of cute.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Hitotsume, I think.
Hitotsume, yeah. So next up we have another, this is the first CD that showed up for them. CD from Hitotsume.
We have Parodies, Onigoko.
Love them.
Same.
Well, lovely Mashido there.
A god amongst gods, let me tell you. Not sure what this is.
I don't know. Oh, next up we have a mini album, Friendly Band Loop. The item code of this is Full Come, and I don't know.
Val's shaking her head at us.
You're welcome, Val.
Glitter Rain from Quest.
Or Quest / Glittering from the band 627,
oh, six.
Which is pronounced Upper for some reason.
We have another CD from Upper.
This one is Ben Hamu no Yenban, maybe. It's a mini album, and it was written with really weird font.
We have another autographed CD from England that I do not know.
I love them. This is... actually, I don't know who this is either.
Your guess is as good as mine.
Oh, I think that's the name of the band, but I don't know how to pronounce that. I've just seen them on Monochrome Heaven. Mm-hmm. Something de ta... There, I'll show the back. that name right there that is probably not going to show up on camera at all, but it's them.
Lovers from band that I don't know.
Asugen? Yeah, something from a bank called Asugen. Oh, I know who this is.
Oh.
There you go, Scarlett. That's for you. That's, I believe, if I'm correct, that's the new band of the members from Xi'an.
Hmm.
Or the vocalist from Xi'an, I believe. There you go. Next up, we've got another CD from the band Sally. Lovely little band. Also, sort of along that same vein of so the Neo Nagoya K kind of like Imure sort of sound.
We have a live DVD from The Raid.
Yeah, like one of their distributed sample live DVDs. We've got I never figured out which one this was. Wow, thanks, band. There's, like, literally no text on the CD or on the jacket. Is there anything inside? Why would they do this? Oh, okay. So, you've got a single here from the band Bask in the Deep, who is, again, another one of those bands that is sort of along the same lines as Imure and whatnot, so... They are cool, but they're dicks for not putting any text on their CD.
We have something from Hysteric.
Yeah, here you go, Allie.
Another something from Hysteric.
Okay, and then we've got, this is the live limited single Up Downer / Saison Melody. I believe this was sold at their last live or during a revival live?
We have another autographed CD, Arrival Art, Montreal.
I think Arrival Art is the band name. That sounds familiar. I don't know anything about them, though. But the name does sound familiar.
Double Made, Double and Double.
You don't
double.
Have that, Tally. Yeah, another, actually a PV DVD from DDD. Oh yeah, Devil Made Devil and Devil. Lovely title. Or band name, rather.
We have some live release.
Ooh. We have, this is a Privilege DVD. So this was a Privilege DVD if you bought one of Marco's CDs at their live booth. So probably hard to get in hold of, I would assume. And yeah, the stream will be uploaded later on. It should automatically go up, assuming it doesn't get copyright stricken.
DVD from Gezi Gezi.
Is that who this is? Oh,
yeah.
I see. Really long. Is this a DVD or a CD?
Maybe CD.
I don't know. It has like a million tracks on it. I'm assuming. This is what it looks like. There's a bunch of names.
CD from Gezi Gezi.
Doku, I think.
Ramiel. Cute band.
Mm-hmm. This is number AA682 out of something. I think this was a sampler. Oh, it was the live distributed CD Love Song.
Mm-hmm.
from Amiel. I don't remember the name of this band. Denki something live distributed CD. And then, Atogaki Logic. I don't know if that's the title or the band. It's literally just a white CDR.
We have Verzel, Encounter of the Circus.
Verzel? I don't know how you pronounce it.
I think another CD from that Unexplained Phantom, maybe?
No, this is a different band. It's like Kyo or Dasen or something. Maybe. It's a CD that from that, I believe.
Has half on it.
Oh, another live distributed CD from the band Sally. This one, I'm assuming, is rare. I think most of their CDs are pretty rare.
9mm, go around.
So this is the first ever single from the band Marco, 9mm Go Round.
We have another autographed CD from Hugh.
Does this one have any naughty words in it again?
Maybe.
Okay, well, if they are, they're written in Japanese, so.
We have the last song also from Hugh. Delta Arc case.
I don't know if this is a single or a mini album or a full album or what it is. Given the price, I'm assuming it's a mini album. It's like $25.
We have another single, I believe, from Upper.
This is Paradisu.
We have another omnibus with Seed, Paradis, Marielle, and two fans.
And Dallas. Vivid Monster Shake Box, which I think is... Yeah, this is where, like, a bunch of the bands are covering other bands. So, M is covering Seed, and, like, Seed is covering, like, Dallas, and... There's a whole bunch of things like that going on, so, you know, really cool sort of things. Shuffle.
We have, Chick Chair Punk from Age of Punk, and it is autographed.
Yeah, I think Age of Punk is the band of Jake, maybe? Asaki, who is the guitarist from Guna Tools. It's one of their full albums.
We have Masquerade from Despero. And this one's autographed as well.
This is totally gonna fall down.
I think this is another Upper CD.
Yeah, Gradation from Upper mini album.
Cloud Chair Live Archives.
Super rare CD from Cloud Chair here, which was the solo project of Jake from Guna Tools. So it's like, it's 9 live songs, and I'm assuming this was like live limited. Like, I could literally find no info about this online at all, so.
Deloisia Bonjour, I think.
Yeah.
That's how you pronounce it?
Deloisia? Yeah, I think so.
Neosonic Arts, it's also autographed.
Yeah, you got a autographed Neosonic Arts Smile Missile mini album. Lovely band if you're into 90s Oshade.
Looks like an early Vivid CD.
Yeah, the 90s Vivid, or early 2000s Vivid. Different Vivid. This is the TV Star, no, whatever.
Who's playing Radio in the background the TV right star. Now?
I have no idea. I can't see.
Faith Endless.
Yeah.
God, Yobi keeps getting stuck. That's just how I'm gonna open CDs from now on. I've learned my lesson. You have another omnibus that has Eternity, Syndrome, Mirage, and two others.
Okay, so this one has Karen, which is... they would later go on to be Karen in Undercode, but this was before they were even on Undercode. So, super rare. Has their song Eternity, has the band Buzz, Et cetera, Deus Ex Machina, and Uranus, which was the band of Aki from Sid, I believe. It's one of the members of Sid was in that band. Super rare omnibus. I don't know when this came out or any other info about it, but I've seen it like once before. This is the single. Thank you to you, Stardust Yeki. This is the single Miradeta Karani Hakorosu from the band Miradeta, which I think some of the members of Kiryu were in that band. That might have been Hiyori's old band, potentially.
We have Collation from The Chain, or The Chain?
The Chain Compilation.
Piranha Heads, fill in the blanks.
I have no idea who Piranha Heads is, but that name sounds... That says Hitoki, so it was the band of Hitoki from... Allie, help. I always forget who Hitoki was. He was in some major band. Maybe Lark or Lunacy. Kuda Yume, thank you.
Alt Mission.
Yeah, so a mini album from Alt Mission.
Elysion, The Fuzz.
The solo project of Shun from Jills.
Violet Narcissus.
I don't know the name of that one, but Kagami no Nakina. I can't read that, and it's actually written out, you know, I still can't read it. Kagami no Nakani from Violet Narcissus.
Cinderella from Vivid.
Classic. I need to create a new file here, otherwise these movies are gonna go flying.
Miselina Ray.
See, I knew that I'd be able to, like, trust Allie to help me out on that one. So, thank you for being there, Allie. Yeah, Tokimeki, single from Miselina Ray, another classic.
Fatima.
Yeah, some single from Fatima, I don't know the name. Something Senai Ame.
Some CD from a band called Bug Scream.
Ah, classic. I like the cute little, like, chibis they have. Yeah, this is the single Abuse from Bug Scream. And it has a cute little chibi art of the band, and it is signed as well.
Romeo. It's signed.
Yeah, signed CD, single from Romeo.
Not sure.
this is another single, or sorry, mini album from the band Silence. That showed up earlier. This one might actually have like more info in it as to who the other members are. It's So from Imure, Zul, who is in some band, Commando Qual, I think, maybe? And then some other person who I don't know. Or Zul might have been in the Caddy Spooky Theater, because they're thanking them.
God, that was a good band. Glam Scare's Subliminal.
Ooh, I like the art on that one.
Mm-hmm. The name on this sounds familiar.
Another one from Kina Duda. Another CD from Kina Duda. Kudo Ikiseki.
I assume that this is the same.
Yep, another Kina Duda. Has a cat-headed person on the art.
We have a CD from Six Squared.
Six, I think they're pronounced. Yeah.
Is it?
Six. They actually read it.
They keep changing it.
this is the single It's a digest single for their first mini album, Pussycat Missile. I think both of the songs are on there, yeah. So it's two of the songs from that album, or that mini album, rather.
We have a CD from Love Teak Chocolate, and it comes with a flyer. I think it's a sample.
Could be. Just as live distributed. Single. Whatever it was, it came out before their first.
Oh.
What about it? Oh. What? You can see it fine. I'm looking at it right now. Looks all right.
We have a CD from Grout.
Nice name. So some sort of mini album, yeah, from a band called Grout. It is signed and comes with a little photo card of them in there. I don't know who they are, but they look all right.
We have another Raid DVD that also comes with a flyer.
So, what do you think? Just the name of the DVD? No.
Not sure. Band logo looks familiar.
And I do not know. Yeah, it has like little logos, two little like
stickers.
Logo stickers, but I can't read the band's name. Looks like Gumu, maybe? Gum? Gudu. I think they were an all-female VK band, if I remember correctly.
Oh, hi Molly.
Oh, hi Molly. It says, what exists in the other side of this door? Question mark. Hi, Val. Okay. I'm going to take a short break for a moment, and we will be right back.
Mm-hmm.
Are you gonna join us this time?
Hi!
You have a cue? She finally decided to join us?
She made her just stream debut finally!
Mm-hmm. Thank you, cue. Good girl, cue.
My hand's gonna be so wet after this!
Okay.
Hell yeah!
So next up then, we have a distributed CD from the band Dion Slave, or Dion Slave. Don't know who they are, but there's three songs on it. Oh, a huge stack of distributed CDs. Next up, we have a some sort of distributed CD with a song called Goodbye This World from the band Vivalette. And we've got another distributed CD from Misaruka for their single Meadow, or Meadow.
We have Mirrors from Corpse Corpse.
That sounds like a band you would like. Just going off the name, Corpse Corpse, sure.
Hypno and Morphe from More.
Their catalog disc, which I think is like a preview of their music videos, I believe.
We have Despina's Sorrow and Room.
Another live distributed, I'm assuming. They've got a CD, Apudai to something from a band who might be called Buddha, potentially. I don't know. That's all you get. That's all the info you get.
A Buddha CD from Project L.
Hypersonic Boy. You get the... Oh, it's also signed. So, signed CD from Project L. Hypersonic Boy / Starlight Logic.
Love Stripper.
This one is a digest of one of their singles.
We have another duplicate of Hypno and Morphe from More. Maybe More. Probably More. Not sure.
No barks.
Give her something to distract herself. Excellent commentary from Katie.
She really brings it all together. Okay, next up we have some single called Something Reality. I don't know who the band is because it doesn't mention it anywhere. So I'll Google.
Not sure.
Next up we have another live distributed single with three tracks from the band Sally.
You have Heretic Adventure from Eternal Period.
Or the other way around.
Other way around.
That comes with a little flyer. Heretic Adventure. Adventure, rather. We've got another live distributed CD from Sally. Something Melancholy.
By Sierra Fiora de Fleur.
So a caseless version of the single Fleur de Fleurs from Bizier. They're like first single. Next up, we have one of the singles from Kimi wa Boku, I believe the name is. We got another single, or DVD from The Raid, one of their, like, live distributed DVDs.
Penny's in my, not sure, but I like the art on it.
Oh, but they're doing the finger thing. Why would they do that?
Butter, I found something cursed for you.
From Benny Zemi. Benny Zemi is a very cursed band. They're like a VK noise band.
Oh,
and they're
oh boy.
wild.
Do you have some dog food?
Maybe.
You gonna read that too?
Oh, yeah. Kimi wa Sudadoku. That's the name that I keep pronouncing wrong. That's what it is. That's all I see from them. Okay, next up we have a live distributed, I'm assuming, single from the band Chocolateholic, which was a side band of the vocalist from... I don't remember. His name was like 9, like the number 9, I think, but I can't remember exactly what it was.
We have
a CD. Okay, here you go, Scar, if you're watching. We have a single from a band called La Flasia. The songs on there are Rosy Memories from Transylvania with Love. I don't know what that is, but that sounds right up your alley.
We have Orgy of Villains from Dato...
I think Orgy of Villains is the band name, maybe?
Are you sure? Isn't that, like...
That is, but it... I don't know. I feel like I've seen the name Orgy of Villains at some point.
Imitation? Not sure.
Some live DVD from the band Shibire Bashiru. It was a released back in 2014 and has a live version of their song Akai Sora ni Chainsaw.
Coming in with a Warner Bros. copyright claim. New story log.
We've got let's see here, a mini album from the band Kalavnica or Karavinka. 6 songs on there. Their stuff's pretty hard to come by, so if you're looking for it, well, there you go. I think I was responsible for spreading wrong information about that band back in the day, saying that that was the band, the like new band of Arisugawa Arisu from Misalina Ray, but there was a bit of a confusion on the internet, and I helped spread that wrong rumor.
You'd be proud of yourself.
Next up, we have some sort of distributed CD from a band called Retu, maybe? Retunes?
Retunes?
Well, it says Retu, and then like there's like another little flyer inside that says Retu News. Doop derp. So yeah, some sort of thing from a guy named Retu.
More boxes.
Okay, next up we have the PVDVD Hypno from More. This one comes with a lovely little photo set and sticker inside of there as well. Absolutely beautiful band if you've never... like, seen them or heard them. They were the newer band of the vocalist of Sugar. Next up, we have a live distributed CD from More. This is the acoustic version of their song Dawn. Then we've got a signed privileged DVD from Marco for their 9mm Go Round single. This was given if you bought the single at their live booth. Then we've got the single Mellow from Bask in the Deep, which is also signed. We've got the Smileberry music video DVD Smile. Let's see here. I'm assuming these are two different things, two different caseless things. We have a caseless version of the full album Strip the Emotion from Cinema Strip, and then something that just says You Kiss, Dora Dora Believe. That sounds like a J-pop thing, but I don't know, maybe it's something else.
We have a bag of a bunch of Kirito.
Oh, we'll have to go through those. Mm-hmm. Okay, next up we've got a Like an Edison live DVD From Phantasmagoria for their Material Pain. Some sort of distributed DVD. Oh, and then we've got the companion one to that with Pixie Falls on there. We've got the live distributed sample.
Oh, it's K-pop.
Is it K-pop?
Get it out of here.
Why did someone burn a CD of K-pop?
Why?
Why is a good question. Why is it in there with CinemaStrip? Who knows? But next up, we got some sampler DVD or CD from Holy Clock. And then a sampler CD or something from Dokoku.
We have a little traveling mug that says I Heart Kirito's Family.
Not Kirito, just his family.
Just his family.
There you go, Allie. If you want a little travel mug to let people know that you love Kirito's family, then there you go. I'll try and chill it up a...
Get the juices out of here. Hell yeah. Oh, perfect.
You're going to show those off on your camera. What, pal?
Yeah.
If it has Kirito beer in it.
So... I think these are gloves, maybe.
Yeah, some fingerless gloves from Angelo. This is your time to shine, Allie. This is all for you. So Angelo gloves. Says grows up metallic butterfly on it. Arm warmer?
Maybe. It looks more like fingerless, like, but with thumbs. Brand new.
I'm assuming that's another Angelo one. It's a weird wristband.
Yeah. This is hard. I'm not sure what it is.
Allie, help. What is?
What is this?
You got a thing from
Pearl. Oh.
We have another I Heart Kirito's Family wristband.
Yeah, but this happened for As a Bacteria when you were here. Now it's happening. We're coming after all your faves. There's something hard and metallic in here, but I feel like Allie, do you know what this thing is from Perot before I open it up, so that I don't have to open it up? It might be like a mirror or something, maybe a little travel mirror, maybe. Maybe something different?
Probably.
I'm really bad at tying things, so I don't really want to like untie it.
It's a mystery.
It's a mystery. I'll leave it as a mystery for now.
I assume this is another weird glove. Kirito, the fish of...
Is it Mir? Okay.
Andy? Question mark?
Yeah, another arm warmer from the Peppa Pamlin, from Kyoto.
We have this.
Another Perot shirt.
Nothing on the back.
Does it have a size on there?
The size has been cut off.
Uh-oh.
But it was from 2002.
Alright, some 2002 tour from...
Psychedelic. Heaven.
Yeah, Psychedelic Heaven from Pedo. I don't think it's a large, it's probably like a medium or free size.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it doesn't look tiny though, so is that at least. I'm gonna go through this bag of things. Okay. So, kind of lighting sucks here. I'm trying to read this.
There's like Lego mittens in there.
Yeah. Well, there's a little rubber band thing, potentially, from some Kirito band. We've got little wristband there. It says existence proof on it. We've got little Pierrot Lego man.
Good thing no one cares about Joel Pierrot.
Another Pierrot Lego man. And another Pierrot Lego man. And another Pierrot Lego man, and a little, like, Pierrot keychainy thingy, mabobber, and
is that like a your sweatband?
A little sweatband your finger, potentially from Pierrot as well. It's so tiny and cute. another little Kirito pin.
We have a Kirito small vacuum sealed shirt.
Yeah, some shirt from Kirito from the Peppa family. It's a size small.
We have a Angelo towel, failed sign.
What's up, Pal? There's only tiny things on there right now. I've got another Kirito little keychain thing. we've got another little like Pierrot or Kirito finger warmer, finger band. Ah, see, I know what this is because we got another one. Okay, you've got a Kirito mint holster for your mints. Yeah, it's a mint case. A little mint case. What is up with Japan having, like, mint case things? I've never seen these before today, but here they are. We got a little Pierrot dice keychain thingy. The tiniest wrists ever. The mint thing wasn't on camera? There. I'm just gonna do these little things and I'll put them back in the bag.
Okay.
Another little Pierrot Lego man. Another little plastic wristband from a 10th anniversary, potentially a Pierrot. A little Pierrot stamp.
Cute.
A little rubber stamper. Another little Kirito keychain thingy. Allie, you better buy all of these and just put, like, every single one of these keychains on your phone.
Do it.
Another little rubber band.
Use it as a weapon.
And another rubber band. And another rubber band. Another little Lego man.
You should get one, Butter.
We've got, some more little, key holders from Pierrot. Another little Pierrot keychain thingy. A metal Kirito pick with a little hole in it, so you could like use it as a necklace if you wanted. Another little Lego man. Another little finger holster thing. You might have enough for a whole hand. So you can wear your fingerless glove with the five fingers to keep your fingers warm. That's amazing.
That's so excessive.
Another little keychain thing and another Lego man and there's a lot more of those. Like there's just more tons of all of those.
Just in different colors.
Different colors, different styles, more finger warmer thingies. Get all of them. If you want all the Pierrot and Kirito and Pirito goodies. knickknacks, as they were. They could be little thimble things, but they wouldn't work really good because they're fabric, so the needle would just go right through them. I literally toss all these back in the bag here.
What this is, but it's a band collab with Gloomy.
That's Kirito and Gloomy.
Kirito and Gloomy.
Towel, or?
Yeah, it's a towel.
Okay.
Oh, that's upside down.
Yeah. So a Kirito x Gloomy Bear towel. There you go, Allie. The creature must be born out of Hades.
Big nerd.
Mm-hmm.
Two vacuum sealed Angelo shirts.
Yeah. No idea what size they are. Oh, this one's open. Kinda. Well, it's ripped open. But I still can't say what size it is.
Yep.
Because it's still sealed. For Kirito shirts. Well, from the stuff of Hamlin.
Maybe it's not for finger.
Oh no. Are we getting lewd in here again?
Maybe it's for toes.
It could be for toes.
Maybe it's for ears.
Mm. Can't prove it.
Neocycle limited showcase.
Perot, maybe? That sounds like a Perot-y thing. Yeah, we can get new bags. I think we have to buy some more of those anyways.
Oh, there's...
two towels. A little hand washcloth thing. Another Kirito thing.
I'll let you put that back together. We have a medium size shirt. That's sealed.
Another Kirito one?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what we're going to do with a million Kirito shirts. Allie can only wear so many.
Allie can make a blanket out of them.
There you go.
Another, well, this one's a period shirt, and it has a very erotic plumaging V down to, like, here.
Wow. show all that 2 inches of cleavage there. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's an Arlequin towel, then.
Is it?
Yeah, I think.
Which one?
I think the white one, maybe.
Arlequin? It should all be Pro stuff, or Pro related.
Maybe.
Yeah, since the shirt actually is not completely sealed in there, if you want to show that one off.
Attack to the Freedom.
I don't know how loud that's going to show.
Oh, it's a long sleeve. And there is.
Yeah, I think it's gonna.
A
really gonna show.
Skull and a rocket on the back.
No idea what size it is. Say.
No.
No. Okay. Looks small-ish. Oh, fan club is Harley Quinn. Okay.
cheese.
Arlequin limited circuit supplemental flowers.
Sure.
Another duplicate. A medium Periat shirt. Another one. Dictator Circus and Act for Original Species. Another medium Periat shirt.
Can I have a few of this?
So,
temporary decision.
That's down in the bottom right corner there.
I think these are some...
Perro Fan Club magazines?
Yeah.
You're killing Ali with your mispronunciation of Perot.
I'm sorry. Perot, oh, okay. Some fan club magazines. I'll let you show them off.
So we've got Tome 18, their 2007 official calendar. A couple copies of the 2007 calendar. Followers, Volume 1. Followers, Volume 2.
It was bound to happen.
Followers, Volume 3. Volume 4. Volume 6. Volume 7. Volume 8. 9. 11 and 12. I don't know where the missing volumes went. Maybe they'll show up somewhere else.
Okay, next up we have two volumes of Interplay members. We've got Volume 5 and Volume 4. Those are Fan Club DVDs, I believe.
Postcards?
Yeah. Yeah, a little postcard set from their tour 2000-2001 Public Enemy, which comes in a little plastic thingy case, which is, of course, very inconvenient way to store your photo cards, but there you go.
Two Perot mirrors of the same design.
Yeah.
I learned my lesson, Allie. Forgive me.
Passport
cover of Angelo.
Yeah.
I think that's everything, unless things like slid in between.
Let's see.
Yeah, that's everything.
Okay, awesome. Okay, so that is everything. So thank you everyone for sticking with us through all of our technical difficulties and the gigantic barrage of Perot items.
And mispronunciation of said items.
Again, if you saw anything on here that you're interested in, just shoot us an email with an offer, and we will get back with you within the next couple of days. We'll give a bit of a chance for people to, you know, send all their offers in and rewatch it if need be. The stream should go on YouTube shortly after we're done streaming. Could be right away, or it could be a couple hours or a day. It really depends on if YouTube is nice or not.
Otherwise, I think that's about it. Do you want to plug yourself again? Do you have SoundCloud or?
What am I, a mixtape for this? Yeah. I'm free. I draw. Hit me a message on Discord.
You do commissions?
I do. My Twitter is Bafafiz. My Instagram is Bafafiz. My Twitter is Epileptic. ZYD. And yeah.
So, thanks again, everyone, and we'll see you later. Bye bye.
Bye.
Let me try not activating now.
Pop that mixtape. My mixtape would probably just be porno grind, to be honest. Yes. That's part of it. Just some guttural pig squealing and KU.